We asked ourselves, when you buy grapes, do you ever dream of buying grapes individually? Never.
Never.
You think about a bunch of grapes, right? So why can't we do the same thing with cherry tomatoes?
With us today is Professor Chaim Rabinovich. The Bible tells us that the land of Israel is the land of milk and honey. And with him, we're going to discuss the whole issue of agriculture. Professor Rabinovich, welcome. Welcome to our show.
It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you.
In Israel, you're known to be the father of the cherry tomatoes.
I'm not the father. I'm a member of a team, maybe head of the team and so on and so forth. But it all started with our previous work on extending the shelf life of the tomato. Indeed, the shelf life of the tomato was extended, but B, the tomato could stay on the bush for a longer period of time, thus accumulate more sugars, more acids, more volatiles. So all the goodies, instead of being compacted into, let's say, 50 tons, is being compacted into 25, so it's even more tasty. Picking cherry tomatoes is laborious. A trained worker with salad tomato who does like that picks about 800 kilograms per day. A cherry tomato is 60 kilograms per day, so it's much more expensive. And we asked ourselves, when you buy grapes, do you ever dream of buying grapes individually? Never.
Never.
You think about a bunch of grapes, right? So why can't we do the same thing with cherry tomatoes?
Oh, beautiful.
So, when a fruit develops seeds, actually a lot of energy, which means lots of sugars, lots of fatty acids, proteins, and so on and so forth, go into the seed, which is the embryo of the next generation. Now, Israel was the first one to develop what we call parthenocarpic cucumbers once they develop without seeds. That means, A, you don't need fertilizers, so you save a lot of the space. Mm-hmm. All the plants are female for this respect. B, cucumbers are much more tasty. And this was spread all over the world. In every field of agriculture that you throw a stone, you find a touch of Israeli innovative approach.
When we talk about Israel, Israel is known that is leading in agriculture. It's probably because of necessity, but in which?
Mainly because of necessity.
Yeah,
it's a combination of very high-skilled farmers, very good supporting system of experts, very good contacts. Most of Israeli farmers are university graduates. And they keep, well, there are very few of them today. There are about 12,000 growers in Israel. And it's not surprising to get a telephone call from a farmer. Look, I was a student like 20 years ago. Mm. I have a problem. Can you help me in answering the problem and so on and so forth? Very high sophisticated seed industry of fruit and vegetables that were developed in Israel and are being sold now all over the world, rather than importing things that were developed, let's say in Denmark, and I have nothing against Denmark, but it is suitable to a different climate,
different soil,
different everything. So by adding this together with good farming, you can get a good produce.
Professor Chaim Rabinovich, what a great insight on agriculture. Thank you very much. And for you, our friend, stay with us for another insight on Israel. Thank you for joining us as we provide a spiritual insight of what God is doing in Israel and in the Middle East. If you want to learn more about what God is doing in Israel, make sure to visit us on our webpage and follow us on social media. Shalom, and God bless you from Jerusalem.